Hello, this is Dr. Radley. I'm a physician in St. George, Utah. And today I'm here to talk to you as patient, but also those of you who are healthcare providers about procalcitonin use in guiding antibiotic therapy for respiratory infections, for acute respiratory infections. So this is a Cochrane database analysis. This was done by Christopher E. Jonas, DO, Francesca Cremino, MD, and Chad Holsculpe. Apologize if I have murdered your name, Dio. This was done through Uniform Services, University of the Health Sciences in Bethesda, Maryland. So a Cochrane database analysis is taking studies that have already been completed in the past and extracting their data out and combining them together so that you have a larger overall number of participants' data that you can look at, which makes the strength of the data and the validity of the findings even that much stronger. So the question that they were looking at is, can using procalcitonin levels help guide antibiotic therapy to do better stewardship over those patients who really should be given antibiotics for treating acute respiratory infections or not? Acute respiratory infections are the most common reason why someone might present to a primary care provider's office or InstaCare or hospital emergency room needing an antibiotic. An appropriate treatment means judicious use of antibiotics. So many times acute respiratory infections are not bacterial in origin, they are viral. And because of that, you really shouldn't be given an antibiotic to treat a viral infection. And so that is why this is being used as a screening test to determine, is this truly a bacterial infection or is this a viral infection? So should you get an antibiotic or should you not? A lot of people will say, well, big deal. So I'm getting an antibiotic, you know, I may not really need it, who cares? Well, antibiotics do come with side effects. And sometimes those side effects can be pretty severe, such as Stevens-Johnson syndrome. So it does make a difference if you're taking a medication that you really shouldn't or need to be using at that time. So the other thing that we find all the time is that we're getting a greater amount of drug resistance to antibiotics where we have organisms that do not respond to antibiotics that we traditionally use. So using antibiotics judiciously, meaning only when they really should be used and not to the vast amount that they're being taken across the board whenever someone gets sick, is also going to help reduce further resistance from being built. And so we want to see improved clinical outcomes, but we don't want to see side effects or adverse effects being taken place because of antibiotic usage. So what is procalcitonin? Procalcitonin is a calcitonin precursor. So these serum levels will rise in the setting of a bacterial infection specifically, not with the viral infection. So if your procalcitonin level is rising and is above a certain level, then you can firmly say, yes, this is a bacterial infection causing this acute respiratory infection and not just a viral infection, and that this would be a case where appropriate antibiotic use would be indicated. So this ended up looking at 26 randomized clinical controlled trials, and they had a total compilation of over 6,700 patients with a diagnosis of acute respiratory infections who were included in this overall Cochrane analysis. So what were the results? The results were procalcitonin-guided antibiotic therapy when compared with routine treatment, meaning the doctor basically saying, I think you have a bacterial infection or not, resulted in decreased 30-day all-cause mortality in patients with acute respiratory infections by 1.4%. So 1.4% isn't huge. Some people will kind of be like, well, really, is it worth doing that, you know, considering the cost in the light of this? But again, this is preliminary data. This is not a recommendation that's been made across the board and as a standard practice yet. And it might be possible that as we see this being used at a higher frequency, that might change that outcome. But the other thing that was in that is 30-day all-cause mortality, meaning that anybody who died in that window of 30 days after having an acute respiratory infection was decreased by 1.4%. So if we're saving lives, even 1% of the lives of that 6,700 patients, that's 600 patients who didn't die in that 30-day window after that acute respiratory infection if treated appropriately. That does make a difference. That is significant. What was the number needed to treat to make the difference in that? 71. So out of 71 patients who were treated with antibiotic usage appropriately, you saw that decrease in likelihood of having them with all-cause mortality in 30 days. So that is very strong evidence to be based on. Compared with routine treatments, procalcitonin-guided antibody therapy also resulted in 2.4 fewer overall days of exposures to antibiotics. So again, using them more judiciously. And a fewer overall antibiotic-related adverse events. And so 16% in the procalcitonin tested group before they were treated versus 22% in the control groups. So that's pretty significant amount of reduction in adverse events. So what kind of things would be an adverse event with these antibiotics that we're talking about? So for example, a rash, allergic reaction, intestinal problems or diarrhea, those kinds of things that you might sometimes see with antibiotic use. So treatment failures. Treatment failures were defined as death, hospitalization, acute respiratory infection, specific complications such as empyema, which is a consolidation of fluid into like a cyst in the lung for lower acute respiratory infection, meningitis associated with acute respiratory infection, recurrent or worsening infection, or any participants reporting any signs of an ongoing respiratory infection. So if you had failed treatment with the antibiotic or were not assigned to antibiotics in the first place, then those patients were excluded from this study. So they are looking at the most basic infections in the study, the things that most of us would go to a provider and ask for an antibiotic for, and not the sickest of sickest patients. So that data would still need to be analyzed. So the argument that they make in this article was that procalcitonin can be used quickly, with most in-house laboratory results returning within 2 hours. Well, the reason why I wanted to present this data is, one, this is not something that has been released as standard of care. It is not widely known, at least in the area where I practice, as a tool to be used in diagnosing acute respiratory infections. So I thought, well, okay, if this is something that I should be looking at into, if this is cutting-edge science, perhaps I should be using this in my clinic and with my patients. So what would it take for me to be able to use a procalcitonin level to decide if a patient needed an antibiotic or not? So the cost of the procalcitonin test at our local hospital was over $129 that they typically bill to insurances. Cash pay price would run you a little over $50. So that's on top of the cost of being seen in your provider's office. And also, you know, we didn't add in the blood draw fee there. How long does it take for our local facility to get a procalcitonin level back? Well, this is something that is a send-out test for our area. So it would have to leave our area here in St. George, Utah, go to Salt Lake and be run at a specialty lab, and it's usually returned on that same business day if it was received early in the day, if not, probably by the next morning. So that's a delay in diagnosis or treatment by 1 day. Not horrible, but if you have someone who is pretty sick and needs the antibiotic and that's making a difference on your decision-making and whether or not you're going to prescribe for them or not, that might make a difference. So when you look at that totality, is it worth the cost of a delay in diagnosis and the increased end expenditure for having this specified test done to make a determination on whether or not you truly have a bacterial sinus infection, you know, respiratory infection, bronchitis, etc., versus something viral? I think the evidence is still out on that, but it is something that I think we need to be aware of and watching for in the future. So it may not be very long before you start seeing me or other providers saying to you, well, before we give you an antibiotic, we're going to draw a procalcitonin level on you. So until next time, I hope this has been informative, helpful. This is Dr. Karen Radley, a family physician in St. George, Utah, and Pura Vida.